can hit record, which is always good. Chris, maybe just give us a timeline first, you know, what you found out, when you found it, and if you're able to trace it, or what you can give us just in terms of timeline.
Well, we had, you know, we did, our tier one group is our group of our student athletes on each team, in addition to the coaches, the managers, the trainers, and everybody. So within tier one, we test that group every other day or three times a week. We do PCR tests. And so we did a PCR test on the 28th, of which it typically takes 24 to 36 hours before we get the results. So we tested on the 28th, and early this morning we had we got notified that we had positive tests within the tier one of our group.
So does that mean specific to men's basketball, right? I mean, when you talk about tier one.
Yeah, men's basketball. Yeah, right. Each team has their own tier one.
Okay. So. And does it only take one, and could it be coach, staff, or otherwise? I mean, what are the rules in terms of hitting the pause button?
In this scenario, we had multiple positives in tier one. And so there's no reason to question whether you have accurate results or not. PCR is the best you can get. And when you have multiple, it's an immediate pause with the program.
Are you able to say, is it coaches, staff, players, combination, any of the above?
We don't get into specifics. It's just within the tier one.
All right. And tell me about the shutdown period, how this will work.
Well, it's basically, you know, within the campus and city guidelines of 2 weeks. And so we're, you know, we've got people in isolation. We've got people in quarantine. The most important thing we can do, and we kicked into, you know, operation, put everybody in the safest position they can mode this morning. So you get everybody separated, get everybody in their quarantine or isolation space, make sure we've got plenty of nutrition plans set for each one as we go through this. So the most important thing is safety and well-being of student athletes and everybody in tier one. We put that plan in place. And now we'll continue to work through that. And as down the road, we'll start thinking about communication plans. How do you help as we get ramped back up to get back to playing games? But today, the total focus is on their safety and well-being and how we help make sure everybody's in a good space.
And for those 2 weeks, there's no basketball activities other than maybe online at some point, as you mentioned.
Right. Correct. At this point, that's all there will be down the road. But right now, that's not the focus.
What's the level of frustration to get this far to be on the day of the A-10 opener to have this pop up?
Well, level of frustration, that's relative. There's some significant, but, you know, the group has done, I mean, we've gone all fall. There hasn't been a lot of groups that haven't had an issue. And every day when you look on the ticker and you see programs that are having this issue and it, you know, I guess it was our turn. So the critical piece right now is we got to take care of business over the next 2 weeks. And if we take care of business and totally shut this thing down and don't have it continue, this group will be just fine. And so the next 2 weeks are so unbelievably critical that we have everybody separated and we get through this. Because if we do, everybody knows we've got a really successful and competitive men's basketball team. And so it's all, how do we put them in the best position from today moving forward to get there? And so everybody's frustrated, but you know what? It's okay. We'll get through this and we'll be back to playing in no time.
You know, it's interesting. Mizzou football was criticized because kids went home at Christmas. Travis Ford didn't let the kids go home for the holidays, which sounded a bit like the Grinch, but he said, hey, I got to do what I got to do. And yet it still pops up. I mean, what's the lesson there, that you can't win with COVID?
Yeah, nobody has yet, right? Nobody's won with COVID. And you do the best you can and you put the pieces around it. And again, we've done so well. And we'll continue to, we'll get through this and then we'll be back at it and we'll learn from it. And we'll put even more pieces around our young people to make sure they're going to be safe. But again, our total focus today, make sure everybody's safe, get everybody separated, and we'll get through this thing.
How are the symptoms? If everybody, are we mild at this point in terms of the positive?
Yeah, we're not commenting a whole lot about, but everybody's in a safe space and we'll get through it.
How much does it help, which sounds like a dumb comment, but that you did go through this with the women's program? Were you able to learn some lessons with that?
There was a couple learning pieces, and I spoke to Dave Harper, the athletic director at Duquesne, this morning, and they've been ravaged by it worse than anybody. They've only played two games all year, and I kind of talked to him about, here's our plan, here's what we're looking at doing, and he's like, you're on it. Most important, separate right away, keep testing so you know if anything else pops up, and he goes, you'll get through it way quicker than what he said. That's the best way to go about it. And that's consistent with what our plan's been. And we've had great, great help from the campus leadership, who our campus went through it as well as any in the country. We've gotten great support from Dr. Terry Redman and her staff on how to get through it and how to put all the protection pieces around our student athletes.
This is such a good team. We talked about it back in March. The season ended abruptly. Now you're just on pause and you remain upbeat, which I appreciate. I wonder if you have to say to the kids, hey, hang in there, because it does seem kind of cruel to have such a good team and to have been kind of slowed down a couple of times now. Do you worry at all about that part of it, the psyche?
I think this will ignite the fire even harder with this group. This group is a tough-minded group that I think this will, when we get through this, we'll have some rust that we'll have to – we'll have to get through some rusty moments, but I think this will light the fire even more with this team being focused on what they're trying to do.
And so you guys got word of the positive results this morning.
Correct.
And as your job, how jarring is that call? I mean, I guess you did it with the women's team, but here you were on the A-10 opening day. How jarring was that?
Martin, I like to say it was not optimal.
I think that's fair. All right, so the plan is basically next couple of weeks, just get everybody healthy and then come back and be raring to go. And you feel good about everything you've done, right? So how do you prevent it if you have kids staying home for the holidays and you're following all the guidelines? And Hassan French was telling us about how it's all they talk about. How do you move forward and feel confident about it?
Well, I feel very confident that we have worked unbelievably hard to put all the pieces around these kids and that they have tried – as hard as they possibly can. And again, like you mentioned, Martin, the virus is going to win. But I feel very confident that we put many, many pieces around our students to have them have the most success. I also believe that we'll probably get a lot of ball handling done in quarantine and in isolation time in the next 2 weeks. So I imagine we will be working a lot on ball handling.
And then coming out of it, I would think it's got to help too. This is a really deep roster. And you know what? You might need all these kids because who knows what it looks like in 2 weeks. But I think that might be to an advantage for SLU.
Fortunately, our depth, I mean, Travis and his staff have done a great job of having a deep team, all of which are pitching in. You mentioned Haas. Hassan looked as good as he's ever looked in the last couple of days. And so this is a short-term bump. And we'll get through it. And they'll be back and they'll be ready to play and they'll be fired up to do so.
And the A-10 will find a way. You'll get all these games made up. That's sort of the expectation.
That's the goal. I spoke to the commissioner McGlade this morning. They've got many different options and models that they've put together just in case teams go on pause. And so, we'll see how it plays itself out. That's the least of our worries today. We'll start looking at that in the next week to 10 days as we look forward. Where are we traveling? How can we get games? Who's traveling this way? How can we get more games in that type of scenario? And we'll see what happens with other teams. If other teams start having similar issues, we might have to go into a mini bubble and get some games in. You never know. But that, again, today's focus is totally safety and well-being. Get everybody in a good place. Get ready to hunker down for a couple weeks, and then we'll get back at it and be as strong as ever.
Coach K and some others have said, why are we even playing? I'm sure you've heard that conversation. Me personally, I think at some point you got to plow ahead and with all the protocols, do the best you can. How much have you heard that in your world where people have questioned whether it's even a good idea?
Oh, I've heard it a lot, and I'm not going to tell you that I disagree with it a whole lot. The industry has moved forward. We put every piece in place possible. There's a lot of sport that has continued through this pandemic and gotten through it. There's been some starts and stops, but this next 2 weeks is not going to define this basketball team. They've done a lot of great work, and there's a lot of basketball to be played, and I am confident that we will be in a good position as this season plays itself out, and especially at the end of the season when it counts the most.
So you said you don't necessarily disagree with their premise, but you're happy that you are playing?
Well, I think to sit around and complain about the fact that you're playing, we are not in position to complain about that. College basketball is moving forward, and we are very committed to doing it as well as anyone. And so we've spent a lot of time, resources, and energy to put our pieces around these groups to really have some success. And I think we will have it.